morning, y'all. Welcome to Possum Run Homestead. This is Mama V, and we're bringing you another Timu haul. All right, yeah. They reached back out to me again. Loved the first video. So we're going to do a second Timu haul for y'all because I needed a few more things for the homestead. And some things just because I wanted them, you know? So let's get into what we got in our bag today. This is what came. It's a big old bag, all taped up and nice. Got some surprises in there for us. We'll rip into it and we'll see what's in this wonderful bag, see what gifts we have, and some things for me, some things for the homestead. For each of these items, I will put up here the name of the item and the cost of the item when I purchased it. So that'll give you an idea. You know, prices change, but it'll give you an idea of what things were. And if you look at my description, you'll find you a nice code to get you a big old discount. It's a $100 coupon bundle. Okay. Woo, what we got here? We got some amazing things in here. I know it. I just know it. This was really inexpensive, but it's something if you are a homesteader that you can use. Here, this is a lid lifter for your 5 gallon and 3 gallon pails. I have a bunch of 5 and 3 gallon pails here on the homestead that I use for animal feed, for deer feed, for all kinds of different uses. I haul water in it, but as far as for storage, I keep wheat, rice, salt, you know, I keep quite a few things in 5 gallon buckets and 3 gallon buckets for food storage. And this helps me get into it. This is a lid lifter. Really simple, but really useful. Very inexpensive. There it is, and there's the price. Next, we have something else for food. And I've been looking at these for a long time, y'all. And I've wanted one. I have a food saver that I seal my deer meat in during hunting season when I process the deers and get them put into the freezer. I use the freezer storage bags, but it doesn't have like the vacuum sealer attachment. It's an older one. So this right here is a lid sealer, vacuum sealer, individual for my regular and wide mouth jars, my mason jars. This is awesome. And I chose the black. It it has a little pop top thing. And here it is. Has a little rubber gasket here. It goes over. It's rechargeable with a USB type plug right here. It's digital readout on the top of it for your pressure. Put it on there. We've got the adapter for the regular and the wide mouth jars. So this will help me seal up my dry goods in my mason jars. That's awesome. I've been wanting one of those for a long time. I just never have gotten around to getting me one. Well, now I got it. There's the little cord. All right. That's number two. Jar sealer. There's what I paid for it. Number three, what do we got in here? Aha. Right here. There's more. Come on. I thought this was just one, and evidently it's three or more. Okay, I thought there was just one, but there's multiple of these. They are wooden. They are wooden. I know that I want to open it out here. I could open one of them. Yeah, it's resealable. So. Let me open this one. I'll show you what it looks like. these two up here. It's a ladle. I don't have any ladles. I've got all kinds of kitchen stuff, but I don't have any ladles. And this is a wooden ladle. Wooden. So, very nice finish. It's gonna come in handy for chili, for soup, for... Yes, I love it. Awesome. And really inexpensive also. There's the price. There's what it is. And these are the wooden ladles. They're pretty awesome. Like I said, I was expecting one, and there's at least three. The way Temu packages their items is they put everything together and then bundle it in a coating. It just depends. Now, some things have come in boxes. Some things are just in bags. Like, this is in a box. Whatever this may be. We're going to find out because it's not labeled. So let's open it up and we'll see what we got. This one's packaged pretty good. Here we go. And we have a soap dispenser. This is a soap dispenser for my sink. This is going to be for the sink in the cabin right back here behind me. I had one of these in my bus. I loved it because you don't have to reach for your detergent for washing your dishes. I personally use an earth-friendly detergent because I'm off-grid and for the most part, and I don't want to be putting detergents onto the ground out here that are going to harm the animals or nature. So yeah, but I can put that in here. This will be mounted right beside the sink in the kitchen, right here in the cabin. You'll see it coming up. And there we go, we have our wonderful soap dispenser. Here we go. All right, that is number four, y'all. There it is, the price for our soap dispenser. What do we have next? Let's pull a bag out of here. We've got a bag. Let's see what's in this bag right here. It is taped up good. There we go. And we got another bag. We've got a bag inside of a bag, yo. Let's open this one up. We have a cord. Not just any old cord, y'all. Here's our thing. Let me show you what this is. This is for my four-wheeler. On my four-wheeler, I have a light, a really nice light in the front of my four-wheeler, but it gets covered up by stuff that I keep on the front of the four-wheeler. So, you know, when I'm hauling stuff or when we're going down to the river or going down camping or something with me and my neighbors out here, we'll take the four-wheelers. And I've got baskets on the front. And I don't think I've really showed you much about the four-wheeler, have I? But it just got fixed recently, so it's finally operable. But now it has a gas leak. Yeah, things happen. Got to take it back to the guy who fixed it. Anyway, it's been a major blessing up here on the homestead. And I've got a wagon that we can haul things back and forth, like rocks and brush and that kind of stuff. So the yard's going to start getting cleaned up from the brush and the branches and the leaves. Because I can use that wagon now that is attached to the back of that and pull it with the four-wheeler. But I want to put a bright light on the front of the rack on the four-wheeler. And this is a switch. This switch gives me the ability to turn on and off the light from the handlebar instead of Yeah, trying to figure out how else to turn it on and off. So yeah, that's what this is. It's a light switch. This is the Allen key for it. And that will help me have light on the four-wheeler. If you need a switch that will fit on the handlebars of a four-wheeler or an e-bike or even a bicycle, anything, scooter, e-scooter, anything like that, this right here will make it easy to hook it up. Very simple. Just hook it into your battery. There is what it is and the price. So, very inexpensive also, but very good quality. It's metal. It's good stuff. We've got another box here, y'all. Let's see what's in this one. Ooh, yeah, this is cool. This is cool. So, when you do a review like this for Temu, sometimes they'll give you an option of some things that you can buy for a certain amount of money that you can choose from, and other things you can just choose whatever you want. This is one of those items that was on the list of things I could choose from, and I have actually looked at these a few times, and they're pretty cool. It's got a little leather sheath. It's got a little carabiner here for your pants, for your belt loop. This little carabiner here for your belt loop. Open it up, and what is this? It's got an inner sheath because it's sharp. It's a little auger. It's a little wood auger. Hope you can see that okay. Put this right here. There it is. Little wood auger. You stick a stick or a rod or anything through here, and you can auger out a hole. You can use this part right here to make a tenon. So you can like build wood furniture and stuff with this thing. This is amazing, and it's super sharp. It is super sharp. It's heavy duty. So in this part here, you can make your tenon. You can take your piece of wood, put it in there, and pound it to make your little tenon to be the right size to go in the hole that this makes. And then use a pole or something in here, auger out your hole for the tenon to fit into. Pretty awesome, y'all. And it's got this inner sheath that protects it, protects your blades. That's pretty cool. That is pretty cool. I'm kind of glad they had that on that list. There's the name, there's the price. We'll put this one aside and see what's next. All right, what, should we pull something big out of here or something little? Let's get something else little, because this goes with the thing I was telling you about before. This is the LED light for my four-wheeler. These are brackets to hold it. So, you know, I'm talking about the LED lights a lot, but it's something important on my four-wheeler. So, I got a few things for my four-wheeler, including that switch and these brackets. Pull this out of here. Here we go. So this fits on, and it's got these adapters here, little rubber adapters, to make it fit really tight, and it goes on to your handlebar so that you can mount a light. The light mounting brackets. Are we seeing a theme here, y'all? Are we seeing a theme here? Light mounting brackets for the four-wheeler or the scooter, or the e-bike, or the bike, or whatever you want to put them on. But I'm using them for the four-wheeler. You see a theme going on here, right? This is the four-wheeler show today. All right. So there's those. And I did get a couple of things that were just for me. fun things, you know? And I'll show those in a minute. We've got some boxes here. Different stuff. Got some boxes. But we should have... Oh, here's a fun thing. It's stuck to the bottom on the tape. Look at this. Look at this. It's a little chicken. It's a kitchen timer for my kitchen. It's a chicken kitchen timer. It is so cute. It's even got tape over the little... It's even got tape up here. Keep it from getting scratched. We've got a little piece of tape right here to keep it from like turning on during delivery, but it's so cute. And yeah, I'll put that in my kitchen in the cabin. All right, next is something just for me. This just made my heart so happy when I saw these and I had to have them. I rarely buy anything just like for fun for me. But I had to have these, and it was in my budget, so I did it. I did it, y'all. I did it. I did it. I did it. Okay. I did it a couple different times. I got a couple of different things that are just for me, but this here is a outdoor... movie projector screen. Just white material that is supposed to be thick enough where you don't see through the back of it. And these are the cords to hang it up with. And eventually, not right now because I'm still building, but eventually this will get hung up out by the campfire area. Because I do have a projector. I've had it for years and never even opened it. Long time. When I still lived in the bus on the road. It's been a while. And I had that thing. And I've never even opened the box. It's still brand new in the package. And I think that it would be really cool to sit out by the campfire and watch YouTube. So that's why I got this. I was going to get it on the last Temu haul, and it didn't fit into the budget, so I didn't. But this is going to be amazing. Watch for upcoming videos, because you're going to see this in action before too awful long. As soon as I get that campfire area set up better, I'm going to move it to the other side of the yard and set me up an outdoor kitchen and everything. All right, some small things. This is kind of a just for me type of item also. It was inexpensive, but it's real leather. And I kind of needed it. Because mine is getting pretty rough. And I've never had a leather one. This is a watch band. Genuine leather, y'all. A watch band for my Apple Watch. Everybody knows I have an Apple Watch. I've had one for years, and it helps keep me safe up here on the homestead, because I'm out here alone, I'm working alone, etc., etc. And with my health also, I really needed this for my protection, because the Apple Watch will call. I have set up in here both 911 and my family and family's numbers, so that if I was to take a really hard fall, which I have several times, it happens more times than I would like to admit, because of my health and sometimes just because of my clumsiness, but this will prompt on here for me to turn the setting off. It'll say, hey, you've taken a big fall. Do you want me to call 911? Do you want me to call your emergency contacts? And I have to turn that setting off every time that happens. I'll hit it. No, I'm okay. Nope, I'm gonna live. I'm okay. This keeps me safe up here. It's an extra layer of security for me. The only reason I have it, because, you know, I'm not really that into technology. So there's a reason for this, having this. It's an expensive item, and it's costs extra on the bill every month, but it protects me. It helps protect me. But I've had this terrible band that I got at a flea market many years ago. I got that band, and it's a metal magnetic band. It's worked, it's been okay, but I'll sit that right there. It pinches my arm. It not only pinches my arm, it pulls the hairs. It comes off. It loosens itself up, and then it's hanging down on my hand. So these right here, we're gonna try them, and we're gonna see what we think. Slide it in there. There it goes. Locks tight. Says genuine leather on the back of it. This will take some working and getting it loosened up, getting the leather loosed up. I always wanted a leather band. You will be shocked by how inexpensive this leather band is, though. And it's actually fairly pliable. I mean, it's not thin at all. It's not thin, but it's actually very pliable. It's nice. It looks like these and these buckles are plastic, not metal, like I was hoping. But, I mean, they fit in there good. So hopefully they'll hold up. All right, let's put this new one on. Let's see what we think. Does it fit? Yeah, it fits. Okay. How's that? That looks like a good one. That fits pretty good. I like it. Look at that. So there's the watch band, leather. You can pick it up on Temu. That's gonna take some getting used to for me, because I'm used to that that metal mesh band. It'll take some loosening up and me getting used to it, being different, but man, it looks good, don't it? It looks so good. All right, you can pick that up right there. Temu, there's the price. All right, we're gonna move on now. Something else for the four-wheeler. Very inexpensive, but very needed. I'm having trouble with my gas fuel cap vent. It's a little hose that goes from the top of the gas cap, and it goes over into the handlebars and vents there. And it's awful. It pulls off all of the time. It's in the way. When I move the steering wheel, it pops off. This is a vent cap right here. This right here is a vent cap, and it has its own vent up here on the top. It's short. It'll just pop right on there. The red matches my four-wheeler. It'll pop right on there. There's the price for it, what it is. And it's another little inexpensive thing from Temu. And there we go. That's cool. Put this with the other stuff for the four-wheeler. I'll show you one day. I'll show you putting them all on. All right, we're back to talking about just for me, just for Mama V. Just look at my stuff. I very rarely get anything for myself. I usually just get practical stuff for use on the homestead, because I'm kind of a practical person. You know, there's things I need here more than I need really stuff from me. But you know what? Every once in a while, you come across an item that is just like, oh my gosh, I gotta have that, y'all. I gotta have it. And I had to have these. I had to have these. They're not as cheap as some of the other things I could have chose to get more of instead of one thing. But you know what? I had to have them, y'all. Watch this.
Watch this. Okay, let's get this open. They're adorable. Cow slippers. I got slippers. I don't have any slippers. So, yeah, I was kind of excited to see these. And they're so freaking cute. Look at that. They're little cow slippers. They're hooked together. There, pop them apart. Look at that. I've got slippers. I don't want to wear them out here because they're white and I don't want to get them all dirty. But they're cows. They're so adorable. Look at that. Look at that. They're so cute. I got cows. I got cows. They're so cute. Y'all, I know. Girly stuff. You know what? Four-wheeler stuff, girly stuff, auger stuff. Yeah, I'm all over the place, but that's me. That's just me. I do like little things like this for myself every once in a while. You know? There we go. If you want some cow slippers for yourself, check out the link in the description below. And there's the price. And there's the item. Next. This one's got some jingle to it. This is for the four-wheeler, y'all. We're back to the four-wheeler. I told you it was gonna be all over the place, right? Here we go. Bolts, screws, and what do we got for the four-wheeler? Can you guess? All right, you've had a chance to guess. Here it is. Remember that light bar I was telling you about that I wanted? I got it. Look at this. This sucker is gonna be bright. This is a 300 watt, 30,000 lumens light bar. I tell you, it's gonna light up the world around me. It is going right there on the front of my four-wheeler. That's what I got the brackets for. That's what I got the switch for. All this stuff's gonna work together and this thing is gonna light it up. It sure is. So check out the link in the description. Grab your $100 coupon bundle from that link too. And check out this light bar. Here's the price on it right there. This is the next item. It's for my camping area. This is gonna go kind of along with that projector screen that I showed you. And yeah, here we go. Here. This is the top of it. And this is the bottom of it. What this is, it's a tripod. It's a tripod for my little stand, for my projector. It goes like this. And then this little table sits on top of it. And you sit your projector on top of that. So, you want to watch some big time screen. Yeah, that's what this is for, right here. Take this little stopper out of here. Here we go. There we go. We got a nice little stand for the projector. Sit right up here on the top and be protected. Keep it from falling over. Nice and sturdy right there. Get it on stable ground here. It's nice and sturdy. And yeah, I think this thing is heavy. Set that on there. Works pretty good, huh? Yeah, it's not on stable ground. It is kind of on a hill going that way. So it's probably leaning that way, which, yeah. Let's see if I can get it on flatter ground. There we go. So this is a really heavy light. It's that big old LED light. Pretty heavy. Look at that. I wonder what this is. It's a metal detector. This was on the list of items that I could choose from. And I was like, hey, cool. I ain't had a metal detector in a long time. Let's give it a shot. Let's see how it is. So there we go. We have a little metal detector. Well, to see if it works, gotta put some batteries in it. Let's see what it takes. Ooh, 2 9-volt batteries. I don't even have any 9-volt batteries. We'll bring it back and show you later, I guess. I'll have to pick up some 9-volt batteries. And you can hook some headphones into here. It shows you low battery. It shows you the sensitivity right here on this reading. This is your power switch, your mode of how sensitive it is over here. And this discriminates against what kind of metals is what it does. There we go. We'll have a little metal detector to play around with on the homestead. It'd be great for a Christmas present for your grandkids or your kids. Would be fun for even for an adult for a first metal detector and to just kind of scrounge around the homestead and see what you find. I found all kinds of treasures on my homestead just looking around on the ground. I've found arrowheads, I've found bottles and glass, pottery, an old leather shoe, like a really old leather shoe piece. And I found a lot of metal things too. And I even found some coins. I haven't shared a lot of that with y'all, but yeah, I found all that stuff on my homestead. And just imagine just looking around, I found that. Imagine what I can find with this little guy. Let's find out. We'll figure this one out. I'll get some 9-volt batteries and we'll bring back this and show you a little clip of it sometime in the future. Maybe a little short or something. All right, there's that. This didn't come with the rest of the Temu order, so I'm gonna show it to you now because it was a little later arriving. They were out of stock and it was something I really wanted to get. So, I chose to wait for it. Let me see if I can get it open. Get our little Temu bag open here. All right, I got my knife. Let's get this opened up. Temu has all kinds of stuff. As you saw, we got some amazing things earlier, and they all came together, and they came very quickly. This particular item was out of stock, but it was something I really wanted. So, I went ahead, and I'm like, yep, I'll wait for it. It is a kitchen faucet for the cabin, y'all. Baron, that's enough, Bubba. This is a kitchen faucet for my cabin. Baron's just not having any of it there, is he? Alright, y'all. It's our kitchen faucet for the cabin. Excuse the way I look. I just got done working outside. I'm trying to get everything finished up for the cabin build. For the roof to go on, and that's happening this week. So here's our hoses
And this is the last item on our Temu haul. And it is awesome, y'all. There's the bottom plate. We have the little adapter here. This right here goes through your into your sink. We also have the rubber washer and the lockdown right there. And right here is our faucet. I'll pull this out of here for you where you can see it. There we go. It's commercial style faucet right there. Isn't that pretty? It's got a one-way valve here to turn it on and off. This comes off, moves around, and it also has a little lever here for turning it on and off. This is metal. This is metal. This is metal. This is plastic, and all of this is metal, which is very nice and heavy duty. Kind of surprised for the price of this, which is down there below. We have our faceplate for the counter and all the accessories. We got everything we need to put this together and have a working faucet when I have running water in the cabin, y'all. This is definitely for the cabin. It is awesome. So that actually wraps up our Temu haul. This was delivered a little later than the rest of the items because it was out of stock. And this is what I really, really wanted on this particular item. So I didn't mind waiting on it. So there it is. And very, very excited. So how do you like that Temu haul, y'all? It is awesome. We got a heck of a Temu haul. We've got the projector stand and the projector screen. Got the chicken little timer. Got, all the things. All the things. So if you saw anything you like, jump over to Temu. Take a look. Jump into their app and see what you can find. I like my Temu hauls. They have been great, and I haven't had any items that I've got a complaint about at all. They're wonderful. So check out Temu, check out their app, check out my discount code that I'm putting in here for you, and see what you can find. All right, y'all. That's it for me. We'll see you on the next one. Love y'all. God bless. Bye. All right, y'all, that wraps up our Temu haul for today. To get your discount, head to the description below. Get you a $100 coupon bundle, y'all. $100 coupon bundle by following the link. Download that Temu app to... You can shop on the Temu app or their online store and get some amazing deals. On the Temu app, you get even better deals. So check them out. We'll see you on the next one. Everybody have a wonderful week, a wonderful weekend, and God bless. Love y'all. Cow slippers. They're so cute.